in iniquity, I understand that what I am created in the image of God mentally. I'm created in his image mentally because God is rational. God is not easily angered. God is one who loves mankind because he created mankind. I don't care what you think I'm prone to based on my geographical location and based on the poverty that I came from. I'm begging you to understand that your purpose of being created in God mentally should oversaturate your depression. It should oversaturate your sadness. It should oversaturate your spirit of suicide that comes in you, because you're created in the image of God. That doesn't just mean physically, but it also means mentally. I know what I'm prone to, and I know that because I've sinned and fall short, sometimes I want to go after. I'm prone to go after and get what doesn't belong to me. But my purpose says that I'm created in the image of God, even morally. And morally, I've got to do what's right. I've got to take only what's mine and give you what's yours. And sometimes that means I'm going to get a blessing. And the blessing doesn't belong to me. It's not for me. It comes to me. But morally, because I'm created in the image of God, I've got to give it to you. I'm also created in the image of God. Socially, we think that social media and Facebook etiquette and YouTube etiquette and Twitter etiquette are how we're supposed to conduct ourselves. But socially, we're created in the image of God. Just as God exists in our lives, just as God exists in the Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, God created people in community. God created people in towns and cities. We're supposed to socially love one another. We're supposed to socially help one another, because we're created physically in his image. When I look at myself, I see God. When I look at Harvey, I see God. When I look at Lisa in the back, I see God. Why? Because we're created in his image. When Sister Hannah loves on me, I see God morally. We should see God in everything we do. Why? Because our purpose is such that we're created in his image. And being created in his image gives us purpose over what we're prone to. And ultimately, even though we've gone astray, even though we've had our own way, we understand that Straight Street is calling our name. How do we get on Straight Street? We do what Jesus was trying to encourage the Jews to do, to believe in him. Believe in how? Believe that they beat him for our sins, for our iniquities. They put a crown of thorns in his head because we messed up. They put a cross on his back and marched him up the hill because we lied. We stole. They hung him high and they stretched him alive because we messed up. They pierced him in his side because we messed up. He dropped his head in the lock of his shoulder because we messed up. But that doesn't end there. Our purpose is more than that. He said, I know what you're prone to. I know that the world has you. I know that you're born again. I know that you've done wrong, even after being born again. So I died for you. I died for your lies. I died for your nastiness. I died for your shortcomings. I died for you went your own way. But how do you break it? You break it because you believe that I got up on the third day with all power. Thank you. that power that helps us to come back on Straight Street. It's that power that helps us to come back to a place where we should believe, where we should make sure that as sheep, we go beget some more sheep. Because can I tell you a secret? You don't have to look far for sheep that have gone astray. Some of the sheep that have gone astray, I'm done standing all over the building. Some of the sheep that have gone astray are right in your bloodline. You hear what I say? Some of the sheep that have gone astray is right in your Rolodex. Gone astray. No man knows the day nor the hour when he's going to return or when he's going to call you. Our mission and our witness is not to understand and know when he's coming, but it's to make sure that everybody else understands that he is coming. Some folks say, y'all been saying he's coming for a long time and he ain't came. That's because God's time is not like our time. God's ways are not like our ways. Don't get God fooled or mistaken by how we process things in these narrow brains that are encapsulated in this skull, wrapped in this skin. We're created in his image, but he's greater than that. And we're supposed to be witnessing to his greatness. If you're here today, if you're tuned in with us today, and you don't know the Lord Jesus in the free pardon of your sins, we offer Christ to you not because we own him, but because we have him. And if you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ in the free pardon, and we say free pardon, sometimes we say things and we don't explain them. If you don't know Christ in the free pardon of your sins, that means you don't know Christ, the Christ that already died for everything that you have done. The Christ that already paid the price for the free pardon of your sin. You have a free pardon in your life, and if you have not accepted Christ, you don't have the pardon. You don't know the Lord, won't you come? If you're here, won't you come? If you're out there,